look all good and stuff. Happy birthday!
Thank you! All right, stop.
Happy birthday.
Y'all just made 49. 49 years old. I look good. Go ahead, clap it up. Okay. How y'all doing? Y'all having a good time?
Yes.
Okay, let's check this energy one more time. When I say Reese Poo, I need y'all to say what it do. Can we do that?
Yeah.
Reese Poo?
What it do?
Reese Poo? Alright, let's keep it going. Guess what? I've been doing this thing called back down memory fucking lane because I made 49. Y'all remember the first time y'all smoked weed?
Yeah.
Yeah? Did you get caught?
Nope.
No?
No?
I got caught. No? I got caught. I got caught by my dad, y'all. So I grew up in San Francisco. I'm a San Francisco native. And it was 13 of us in the house. Y'all know what pallets is? Okay, we had pallets all over the damn house. And so I thought my cousins was my homies, man. So one day, man, they set me up. And let me tell you, I went to private school and they didn't. My nickname was Brat. Figure that out. And they was jealous. So one of my cousins, she would always like to get me in trouble. And I used to talk shit all the damn time. But this time, she got me good. So this is my grandmother's bed, this way. This is the hallway, this way. I'm smoking weed, talking to my cousins, and I'm like, ooh, this is good weed, man. I'm still in my uniform, it's all, and my uniform still rolled up all the way up to here. I'm talking mesh, and my dad's walking down the hallway, but ain't nobody saying nothing. And I'm like, and she was like, what you gonna do when your dad comes? My daddy gonna catch me. My daddy gonna never catch me. I smoke weed all the time. My cousin eyes got big. I said, bitch, what's wrong with you? She said, yo, daddy right there. Oh, shit. God damn it. He said, so you smoke weed? Is that a trick question? And my dad always asks questions, and he already knew the answer. But this is obvious. So I said, yeah. So what he did was, he set my blue butt in the room, and he made me smoke weed all day. I was so high. Now, I'm high right now. What I don't understand is, why would you do that to a child? What lesson is that going to teach me? Other than smoke weed continuously all day and eat edibles. Remember the first time you ate edibles? Yeah? How did you feel? What kind of edibles did you eat?
I had a brownie. And I had a cookie and I had some gummies.
I had cookies, and I got them from my ex-husband, and I knew when he gave them to me, he was trying to be a hater, but he wasn't. But I thought he was. So he rolled up on me, he was like, DJ. He's like, I'm like, what's up? He's like, I got four cookies, but don't eat them all, because they got cannabis in them. Now I'm going to a work function. I'm a Niner fan, okay? But I'm going to a work function to the Raider game. I ate all four cookies, so I figured he's a fun fucking snatcher. You're not gonna snatch my fun. So I ate the cookies, and we're sitting all the way up at the top. And all of a sudden, things just start going like this. I was like, oh shit. Oh my God. And I told my coworker, I'm going to the bathroom. And she's like, okay, so I'm going down the stairs. And I'm like, somebody watching me. Somebody watching me. And I turn around, nobody's watching me. And next thing you know, I'm all the way at home. I was that high to use the goddamn bathroom. That damn high. Edibles, you should never eat those on an empty stomach. You will hallucinate. Let me tell you, I was in the shower like this. I was like, it's in there. He was like, what? I was like, the edibles. He's like, my roommate said, well, where are they at? I said, I ate them. They're inside of me. And I need you to get them out. He was like, man, we gotta take you to Kaiser. No, that's white man privilege. They gonna keep me if I go. They gonna put me on 5150, right. And I don't need that.
Yeah.
You're white, I'm black. They gonna keep me, I'm not going to Kaiser. So edibles, I still eat them.
That part.
Yeah, I still eat edibles every day. Every day, I just have one right now. Do you guys remember your first Love?
I just divorced.
I know everybody in here done been in love before. Everybody. You remember your first love? Because I married mine, but that motherfucker didn't marry me. He did not marry me. I met him in the 9th grade. And when I saw him, I was like, oh, God, he is so fine. And I fell in love with the first person I saw all the way till we got married. He had 2 kids. He said, we need to get a divorce. I'm like, why? Then I thought about it. Yeah, let's go. So he filled the papers out the first time he got that shit wrong. And I said, I'm going to go with you so we can get this done. So we get it done. We go down there together. And I was free. I'm like, yes. God dang it. Because look at this body. We got to go get it in because this vagina is gently used. I'm a Christian. And we only did missionary. And I need to learn some new stuff. So I went to porn and fucking popcorn. Not no Netflix and chill. Training tapes. Popcorn and porn, it's the best thing ever. And I learned so much. Not just that missionary where you just like this, you know, I'm looking on the floor, but I don't get my black turn. So I sat there. I don't know how y'all watch porn, but I was in it. I was like, oh yes. Ooh, man, look how she sucking that. Oh, that's called fellatio. That ain't no old, that ain't head. That's fellatio. That's some good shit right there. I learned how to do that. Then I learned, ladies, you ain't gotta ride, just ride your man. Make sure your arches, you ain't gotta ride him. Just ride him, and then when you turn back, look at him. You gotta look at his ass. And go, ruh. Make him know you there. You know what I'm saying? Ruh. Cause I mean business. Gently used vagina, I'm trying to get it in. Not trying to be in love, I'm just trying to get it in. So I was like, now what I gotta do is find me a nice man. So, these dating sites, I don't do that. That's a job. They got this thing called profile. You gonna lie to me, I'm gonna lie to you. We ain't gotta go through all that. It's one conversation. You wanna get it in? Yes, let's do it. That's it, the profile, too long. So I decided I'm gonna go to a bar, meet me a nice young man. But somebody told me I gotta get me an old dude.
Get your sugar daddy.
Sugar daddy. Yeah. Who said that? Sugar daddy. Yes, honey. He was 64. Yes. And let me tell you. Hold on, let me get my spirit right. He was 64. Now at first I was like, that's nasty. Ugh, what am I doing with that? And my friend said, well, you know, he got a pension. I said, whew, I can jump into that. We can do that. You know what I'm saying? If the dick is good and the pension is right, mama gonna be right. So he was 64 and he was hung like a whale. Man, you know, ladies, every time we drink, we get horny, right? I mean, we get like, oh, God, man, what we gonna do? Let me call somebody. He ain't there. This one, he had the telepathy. Every time I get drunk, he called me. I'd be like, yes, baby. And in my mind, I'm like, well, he ain't not a relationship. We just having sex. But he thought it was a relationship, so he would call me. But he would talk to me about stuff I don't know about, like the Rifleman, the McCoys, Ronald Reagan, Ford. I'm 49. And then you can't talk about nothing because you're older than me. And the sex is good, though. And he loved it because when I did the... He said, that was freaky. He ain't never had that before. So he was on it. So he would call me. I was spinning circles like, oh my God, he called me again. I can sit on it again. The last time I sat on it, I didn't think about with older men go. Older people, period. Dementia, senile. Just losing it all. And so I got up and he was like, baby, that was good. He was like, Shirley, you gotta give me some more. Shirley? Who the fuck is Shirley? My name is Sharice. God dang it. So next thing you know, I took a bottle and I threw it at him. Bam, and it hit him in his head. And I was like, oh my God, I'm going to jail. I work for a medical center. We can't hit senior citizens. And it's all bad. I ain't gonna tell you who I work for because y'all might tell. Y'all look kind of suspect. And so I threw the bottle. Then I found out he has Alzheimer's. And so I felt bad. Whatever, don't judge me. He deserved it. And so One last thing. Popcorn and Porn has this thing on here called fetishes, and I love it because if my man ever gets out of place and I have to kick his ass, I'm gonna tell the police he's into fetishes. He loves it when I kick his ass. That's my time, y'all. Thank you.
Y'all make some noise for my girl, Cerise Blantois. Make some noise, y'all. Hey, sweetie, we love you. Tell them what you got next coming up, where you gonna be at.
Next, I have the Wynn Casino in Reading on May 18th. If you wanna follow me, you can follow me at _ Red Lip Bandit Comedy. Thanks for having me. You guys have been wonderful. Give it up for your minion, Swiss Cheese. Thank you, Swiss.